In a first of its kind, the International Criminal Court at The Hague is prosecuting a former jihadist for demolishing ancient sites in Timbuktu, a city in West African nation Mali. This is for the first time the concept of war criminality has been extended from killing people to trying to wipe out cultural heritage. Former Islamist rebel Ahmed Al-Faqi Al-Mahdi admitted wrecking holy shrines during Mali's 2012 conflict and apologized at the start of his trial.
I'm really sorry, I'm really remorseful, and I regret all the damage that my actions have caused. I regret what I have caused to my family, my community in Timbuktu, what I have caused my home nation Mali, and I'm really remorseful of what I have caused the international community as a whole.
Prosecutors say Mahdi led a band of jihadis in the systematic destruction of relics of Mali's ancient culture of pluralism. Using pickaxes and crowbars, they destroyed 9 mausoleums and the door of a mosque. Most of the sites dated from Mali's 14th century golden age as a trading hub and center of Sufi Islam. Timbuktu's 3 mosques and its mausoleums were considered the great treasures of Saharan Africa. Despite the efforts of their custodians, manuscripts and books dating back to the 13th century were lost. The UNESCO called the attack part of a genocidal project and attempted annihilation of otherness. The destruction triggered global outcry. Archaeologists hope the trial will send a stern warning that such plundering of the world's common heritage will not go unpunished. The court will pronounce its judgment on the 27th of September. Mehdi faces a maximum sentence of 30 years, but prosecutors are expected to ask for a lesser sentence given his cooperation. UNESCO listed the city as a World Heritage Site. The city recovered the mausoleums this year, a proverbial rise from the ruins.